strongly that it is possible to influence the young people she works with and make a difference to their lives and aspirations. But some of the people we encountered during the project were sceptical that young people can change. So we decided to look for other examples of effective work tackling gun and knife crime.
This relates to a young guy about 18 months ago. It was about 1:30 on a Monday afternoon and reception have shouted somebody's been dumped at the front of the hospital.
My name's Rob Jackson, I'm what's called an emergency nurse clinician. I work at A&E at the Royal Liverpool, which is one of the major trauma centres in the city. We deal with approximately 100,000 patients a year, and about 4 or 5 years ago, I was asked to go and speak to a group of young offenders about the health implications of knife crime. And essentially, I thought it was a complete and utter waste of time. You know, they would get me and I'd be speaking to these Neanderthal beasts who'd be scraping their knuckles and beating their chests, and that they wouldn't listen. And I was amazed within 20 minutes of my presentation of showing them the images, how affected they were by it.
There was a young man called Joseph Lappin, 16 years of age, probably only 2 miles away from here down in Vauxhall. He was about 4 years, 5 years ago now. He was minding his own business outside a youth group, and he was set upon by a gang of 7 lads, of which one lad had a knife. Case of mistaken identity. Joseph was a promising army cadet, was going to go off to uni and had a great career in front of him. Nice lad, not known to the police. Was stabbed once in the chest. It happened less than 5 minutes away from the Royal, and he was with us less than 10 minutes after it happened. By the time he got to us, he was dead. Nothing that we could do. He'd been stabbed once. But think about this. One person out of that 7 had a knife, but the other 6 all knew that their mate had a knife, and not one of them did anything to stop it. And with a thing called joint enterprise, with that, if our mate down here's got a knife, and 6 of you here know he's got a knife, he stabs me and I'm dead, you're all going to jail. Because you have all known that he's had a knife and not one of you have done anything to stop it.
I've just been into a school now in North Liverpool. I was in a school yesterday in Hale Wood, and I speak to, on average, you know, 150 to 200 people in a large assembly. And what will happen, I'll show these great pictures and, you know, refer to the tales that I've dealt with, if you like, and you can guarantee out of 150, you'll probably lose 30 to 40, of which some will walk out, some will pass out, some will puke. And for which I make no apology, because I would rather see them in that situation then and now, rather than end up having to see them in the emergency department.